Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. Today is the 25th of January 2016. It is very cold outside. The temperature is only 5 degrees Celsius. Today, our discussion is on expanded polystyrene, which is sometimes simply called polystyrene or styrofoam. In this video, we shall explain the advantages of using expanded polystyrene cups in finding the heat capacity of a liquid in an experiment. In a laboratory, liquid is often placed in beakers, which is made of glasses. However, in experiments to find the heat capacity of a liquid, such as water or lemon tea, beakers are not used. Instead, expanded polystyrene cups are used. The reasons are, firstly, a beaker has a high heat capacity. It absorbs quite a lot of energy from the liquid being heated, and this will lead to a significant error in the final result. Secondly, glass is not a good heat insulator. After the beaker is heated up, energy will be lost from its surface, adding to experimental error. On the other hand, an expanded polystyrene container is light, that is, its mass is small, therefore it has a very small heat capacity. Even though its content is hot, a polystyrene container absorbs only a small amount of energy. This reduces experimental errors. Another great property of expanded polystyrene is that it is a good heat insulator. It means that it can maintain a high temperature difference between its two surfaces. That is, even its inner surface is hot, its outer surface can still maintain at room temperature. As a result, there is almost no heat loss from an expanded polystyrene cup. Now note that the lid is important to further prevent heat loss from the content. Do you know why expanded polystyrene is a good heat insulator? An expanded polystyrene is manufactured from hard solid polymer called polystyrene. After expansion, the product consists of 98% of air by volume. Since air is a good heat insulator, an expanded polystyrene cup does not allow heat to flow through easily. Now, the following experiment verifies that expanded polystyrene consists of mainly air. In this experiment, acetone is splashed onto a block of expanded polystyrene. Acetone is a good solvent and is used as a nail polish remover. It is highly flammable, therefore, do not try this at home without adult supervision. When you really want to try this experiment, make sure that there is no naked flame nearby. Notice that the polystyrene dissolves in the acetone quickly. At the same time, the trapped air inside the polystyrene escapes and the block contracts dramatically. This experiment reverses the manufacturing process. The expanded polystyrene contracts and turns back to its original form. In another experiment, the expanded polystyrene block is immersed into a beaker of acetone. You can see that as soon as the expanded polystyrene block is immersed into the acetone, the block disappears almost completely. The remaining substance is quite sticky, but when the acetone inside vaporizes, it will be hardened. Therefore, this can be a good substance for you to mold into any shape you want. In summary, this video provides two reasons to explain why polystyrene cups are used in finding the heat capacity. It has a very small heat capacity due to its small mass. It is also a good insulator. These two properties of expanded polystyrene help us to reduce experimental errors in finding heat capacity. Before we end, I would like you to find out the disadvantages of using expanded polystyrene containers as food storage. Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. Write your comments on the answer of other people's. I hope this video can help you understand more about the experiment of measuring heat capacity of an object. Thank you for watching.